Scientists and cosmologists have long discussed the origins of the universe, an expansion that occurred when high density and temperatures created an event that we know as the Big Bang. So, with all that knowledge of how this all got started, perhaps it's only natural to be curious as to how it'll all come to an end. As it stands, two of the leading theories as to how the universe will eventually be destroyed are known as the Big Rip Theory and the Big Freeze Theory. Both of these provide potential answers for what might end up being the ultimate fate for our universe. But that then begs the question, which one is more likely? Well, in order to figure that out, we need to first understand what each of these theories actually entails. Let's start off with the Big Rip Theory. Physicists trying to understand what the end of the universe will look like have described this as one potential outcome. But in order to understand it, we need to first go over a few important bits of context. Firstly, as you may or may not already know, the universe as we know it is constantly expanding. Over time, the distance between parts of our universe is steadily increasing, and has been since the Big Bang, thanks to the energy of that event. Due to this constant expansion, the galaxies that exist outside of our own are gradually moving away from us. Those further away move faster, but that doesn't mean that these galaxies are moving through space from one part to another. Instead, they're moving in space. The space that they inhabit is also expanding. In other words, the universe that encompasses everything that exists, our own galaxy and others, and everything, is gradually spreading itself thinner and thinner. Now, the second piece of context is the existence of dark matter and dark energy. Those terms might sound familiar if you're a big science fiction fan, but these aren't just cool-sounding words that authors throw into their space stories. Dark matter is arguably one of the most important cosmic phenomena in the universe, and yet it is surprisingly difficult to study because it is incredibly hard to detect. This is because dark matter is composed of particles that do not absorb, reflect, or emit light, hence its name. Thanks to this, it can't be detected or even seen directly. So, how do scientists even know it's there? Well, that's done by observing the effects of dark matter on objects in the universe that we can observe. It collects around every galaxy, affecting gravitational fields and bending light. While everything within the universe is composed of matter, dark matter also exists all across the universe, woven into the very fabric of space itself. Dark energy, however, is not as well understood. It's a mystery, with roughly 68% of the universe comprised of dark energy. This is known because dark energy's primary effect is directly linked to the expansion of the universe. According to current theories on the subject, dark energy is what causes space and the galaxies within that space to gradually move apart on such a small scale that it's almost undetectable. Dark energy has long been thought to be just an inherent property of space. However, this mysterious force is still not fully understood. All we need to know for the purposes of this explanation is that dark energy can overwhelm gravitational and electromagnetic forces, hence why it causes the objects in the universe and the space containing them to keep moving apart. So, in short, the universe is constantly expanding, and that is largely due to the effects of dark energy. Of course, we are simplifying things here. Those concepts are exceedingly complex, and there's still a lot more research that needs to be done into the exact nature of dark energy. But with all that in mind, what exactly is the Big Rip? Well, given the universe is continually expanding at an accelerated rate, the theory states that eventually the universe will hit a limit where this force will begin to deconstruct matter and even space-time itself. Essentially, our universe would be broken down into its basic components, and the gravitational forces between objects would also be pulled apart by the continuous rapid expansion. Eventually, the entire universe will be ripped to shreds on every conceivable level. This includes everything from galaxies to stars, planets, individual atoms, and even time itself, eventually leaving nothing left, hence the name the Big Rip, and RIP to all of existence. While this might sound more akin to something from a science fiction movie, Marcello Disconzi, assistant professor of mathematics at Vanderbilt University in Tennessee, along with physics professors Thomas Kephart and Robert Scherer, developed a new model of the Big Rip Theory in 2015. Using this model, they were even able to give an approximate date of when the Big Rip is likely to occur. So make sure you mark your calendars for it, everyone. It should be arriving in around 22 billion years from now. According to Disconzi, in order for the Big Rip to occur, dark energy will first need to become stronger than the force of gravity until it becomes powerful enough to cause single atoms to separate. In the Big Rip model from 2015, he began examining the viscosity of the universe, in other words, how sticky the universe is, and how resistant it is to not only expanding, but also potentially contracting too. If the universe is constantly expanding outward, will it ever reach the point where it springs back inward? Referred to as cosmological viscosity, this is considerably different from how we understand viscosity of liquid. This is normally measured by how quickly a liquid can move through a small opening. The thicker and more viscous something is, the slower it typically moves. Visconti was able to determine the universe's viscosity is quite low, which means it could theoretically expand to a near-infinite size. However, then the dark energy comes into the mix. If dark energy increases in strength the more the universe expands, and the universe continues to expand, then Visconti's hypothesis states that this will eventually lead to dark energy becoming strong enough to pull individual atoms apart. After all, for the Big Rip to occur, dark energy needs to win its battle with the force of gravity. So, if the Big Rip theory is correct, then this could be how it happens. After gradually getting further and further apart, the space that lies between galaxies would become nearly infinite. Individual stars have drifted away from their galaxies by this point, while planets and everything on them would also be torn apart. These planets would also have drifted away from the stars surrounding them, as would the moons from said planets. Celestial bodies would explode as they themselves were pulled apart by the effects of dark energy. On a microscopic level, molecules and atoms would also split, as the forces keeping them together would be ripped open. Electrons would be pulled away from atoms, all the way down to quarks, the theoretical smallest subatomic particles. If anything smaller than that exists, that too would be pulled apart. This would eventually reduce the universe to its bare components, until it would, in all likelihood, be unable to withstand the immense pressure created. At that point, if you had somehow managed to stick around for that long, you could witness the very fabric of space glitching as it too began to rip itself apart. Reality would become reminiscent of the time before the Big Bang, when there was quite literally nothing in existence. So, that was the Big Rip in a nutshell. So long, universe, hardly knew ya. However, the Big Rip isn't a certainty, and that's not to say we can avoid the inevitable end of the universe, but there are other predicted models for the eventual demise of all existence. One of these is the Big Crunch, which suggests the constant expansion of the universe will eventually begin to slow down rather than accelerate, eventually causing everything to implode, collapsing on itself into a singularity. Think Big Bang, but in reverse. Then there's the much-anticipated Big Freeze. So crank up that thermostat and get ready for an ice age bigger than you could possibly imagine. Except, despite what the name suggests, the Big Freeze isn't everything in the universe dropping to the same low temperature. Instead, it would be a new continuous state wherein the universe itself would be so still that nothing could physically happen. If you thought that the entire universe being slowly pulled apart by dark energy was a sour note to go out on, then this possible outcome is an even more bleak end to the universe. According to the Big Freeze theory, as the universe expands, one day all the energy in the universe will eventually become evenly distributed. This would lead to what is called a thermodynamic equilibrium, essentially a constant level of thermodynamic energy across the entire universe. Thermodynamics, for those of you who don't know, is the science that deals with the transfer of energy from one place to another. Energy can take on many different forms, and in particular for thermodynamics, kinetic energy and potential energy, which are both related to movement or action. So, thermodynamics examines the relationship between those action forms of energy and heat produced by action. One of the key principles of thermodynamics is entropy. This refers to the idea that everything in the universe eventually moves from a state of disorder to a state of order. So, think of entropy as the way in which we measure the shift. According to Big Freeze theory, entropy would increase as the universe expands, and this would continue until it reaches its maximum value. That would mean all the heat energy would be evenly distributed, staying at a level that remains constant across the entire universe. Think about it as being perfectly, evenly, and very thinly spread, so that no part of the universe has any more potential energy than any other part. This would ultimately decrease the temperature not because things were getting colder, but because no heat energy would be produced from action. This is why the Big Freeze is also referred to as the heat death of the universe, because you need energy for action to occur, and with no action, no new heat can be produced as a result. Essentially, in this outcome, the universe would continue to expand thanks to the inflating effects of dark energy. In theory, it would inevitably become so vast that the supplies of gases would also be spread thin, so thin that no new stars could form. No new stars means no heat or light energy, and with nothing being born as the universe continues to expand, everything would essentially grind to a halt. It would all freeze, and nothing would be able to happen due to a lack of energy in the universe. So, when all said and done, which of these unpleasant outcomes is more likely to be the definitive end of the universe? Well, that all depends on who you ask. Different scientists ascribe to different theories, with some of the more optimistic hoping for a Big Crunch. In that outcome, the expansion of the universe would not only eventually slow down, but would also end up reversing, with gravity pulling everything back toward, well, everything else. This would lead to stars, planets, and entire galaxies crashing into each other, destroying all life in an explosive fashion. But as the universe contracts, its heat and density would increase until, boom, the Big Crunch could in essence become the Big Bang recreated, if the universe condenses into a singularity. Some scientists refer to this as the Big Bounce, theorizing this would create an entirely new universe in the place of our old one. This would begin a brand new cycle of the second universe expanding up to the point where it contracts, and then another Big Crunch and a Big Bang happen, leading to another Big Bounce. This means that the universe could just be one big, ongoing, endless cycle of universal destruction and creation. However, most scientists are in agreement that the universe is going to keep expanding, and with no signs of it contracting again, the Big Crunch is unlikely to be the outcome we get. The most widely accepted of the theories is that the Big Freeze will occur as a result of the universe's continued expansion. That is, in a large part, thanks to the existence of dark energy. It's unlikely that gravity will ever become strong enough to counteract the inflating effect of dark energy. And if gravity is weaker, then it can't pull the universe back inward to collapse on itself for the Big Crunch. There is one more, slightly contentious theory about how the universe could end, a theory that's known rather whimsically as the Big Slurp, and less whimsically as false vacuum decay. This theory is particularly strange and complex, as it delves deep into quantum mechanics. In short, what you need to understand is that we exist within a field of energy known as the Higgs field. Ever heard of the Higgs boson particle? This is that same Higgs. You also need to understand that under the current laws of physics, any system will try to become stable, which it does by moving from a state of high energy to a state of low energy. When a quantum field stabilizes into its lowest state of energy, it becomes a true vacuum. The reason this is relevant to our current discussion is that the Higgs field is believed to be a false rather than a true vacuum. And even if one tiny part of space slips from a high energy to a low energy state, it would cause a bubble of vacuum decay that expands at the speed of light, slurping the rest of the universe into it. What would happen in that bubble of vacuum decay? Well, we're not entirely sure. The only thing that is certain is that the universe as we know it would be over. Although it is worth noting that the exact nature of how the universe will end is highly uncertain, and all anyone can agree on is that it's certainly a long way off. So that begs the question, why think about it at all? Well, learning more about the universe and gaining a better understanding about this inevitable end might seem like an exercise in futility. After all, none of us are likely to live to see it. But if anything, what should be gleaned from all this is a better appreciation for all parts of this universe that we call home, and as a reminder that some things might seem like they're going to be here forever, but they will not always. Now watch incredible things we still don't understand about our universe, or look at why astronauts were almost trapped on the moon forever. Apollo 11 landing.